Yes, it's me, market vendor here again today. Well, listen, I want to do a little reasoning here this morning. Now, Professor Sir Henry Fraser, I heard on that magnificent program that when I got this come over 8:15 and then get repeat later in the day, I believe at 5:15 in the afternoon, say that during, you know, it's called what? Did you know? You know that program, right? Coming up every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday on Capital Media HD 99.3. Now, I heard Sir Henry say that in the war days, we used to feed ourselves because we had developed a system of growing things. Now we just grow houses, according to Sir Henry. That didn't make market laugh. But I mean, he wiped his smile off of my face, because at the end of the day, we talking about a world war, and there was at war. But people, we are in a world war. The whole world is at war right now, in case when they realize it. Market know it. But the only problem is that we got a common enemy. That enemy is called COVID-19. So far, it took over a million people all over the world, including some right here, so in Barbados. So we at war. How are we going to feed ourselves if the only thing we're growing is houses and housing developments? And you got these covenants that say you could only keep a dog or a cat. You ever smell cat poop? Or dog poop? I'm going to smell real, real stink. And dog care is a boar cat. Let me tell you something. And he put the marks by the place for about 3 weeks. You can't walk through that place. It smells a stink. So we got to relax some of these covenants and thing a little bit and allow people to feed themselves, grow a little something, keep a little something in the backyard. Even if it's 5 or 6 chickens, a goat, a sheep, something like that, a cow. What wrong with it? You're going to get some natural fertilizer for the garden. You ain't going to bring all them chemicals in the place. Yes, in the old days, that's what we used to do. My grandmother used to bring in barrels and things from fruits and things from St. Lucia and sell them. Yes, she was a vendor. She did vending. And my aunt too as well. So let me get back to feeding myself. I believe if I got a little sheep up in the back and they call it Basil, you know, nothing wrong with that. Because sheep. In the old days, you raised livestock. You had pigs and things. But on the weekend, now they used to have the butchering. And you used to do something called engaging the pork. I never quite understand that. But you call up your people and you had the orders. You engage the pork. What is wrong with some vending? What is wrong with helping yourself? In my day, if you didn't go and pick up the eggs from the fowls out in the yard in the morning, you ain't getting the eggs for breakfast. And don't talk about the goats. You got to go and milk that goat. Let me tell you something, because it wasn't a dairy. These days we get high up and better off. We can't keep nothing. I tell you, God, keep pigs up in a big development. But what's wrong with keeping a little sheep? Or 2 ducks? Or 6 chickens to feed yourself when the day come? We get too, you know, we get too bougie, man. Let me tell you, we got to break it down a little bit. And then you got to be able to grow something. After all, you can't eat the lawn. Now you can't eat the pretty flowers that you're growing out in the backyard or the front yard. Try and grow something that you can't eat. And if all of we grow something that we can't eat, plant up a fruit tree here or there. Everybody in the neighborhood had a sheep or had a goat. And somebody had some fowls and somebody got a few ducks and things. You know, maybe we could all do a little bartering and exchange and help to feed myself, because we are in a world war, people. We are at war, and war requires a different frame of mind. You got to have war rules, and these are the rules that we need to embrace, though. I was only a market vendor, but I tell you straight, I gotta make sure I got 2 sheep up in my backyard, cause let me tell you something. When I holler for some mutton, somebody holler for curry. I gone for now. Have a blessed and a wonderful day. You hear?